In the last part, we have textured the model and baked out the textures for the diffuse map and the normal map. I have added the diffuse map and the normal map directly to the principal BSDF node and removed the other material that I've done. And from this tab, I removed the original UV that were created for the clothes and only left the baking UV. Let's close these tabs. First of all, make sure that the character is in the middle of the scene and the x-axis is parallel to the character. Okay, let's start by adding in an armature. Press Shift A and then armature and then single bone. Go to the wireframe, you'll see that one bone has been added. Press G then Z and move it around here. Go to the material preview, you will see that the bone is not visible anymore because it's inside the mesh. So from this tab, go to the viewport display and select in front. What will that do is it will make the bone appear even if it's inside the mesh. Okay, select the armature, press tab to go to edit mode, select this vertex and then press E to extrude another bone from it. Press Z to move it upwards, like that. Press Shift and right click around the armpit of the character, then press Shift A to add another bone. Put it down like that, scale it down by pressing S, maybe rotate it a little, like that, and put it underneath his armpit, like that. Alright, select this vertex, then press E until you reach the elbow part of the mesh, rotate around like that, and maybe push it on the Y axis a little. Then press E again and put it just before the beginning of the gloves. Press E one more time for the gloves and push it on the Y axis. So it's in the middle of the mesh. Select this vertex, maybe push it up a little, all right. Press Shift and right click to put the 3D cursor here. Then press Shift A to add another bone. Rotate this bone by 180 degrees. So it's looking down. Scale it down and put it around here. Go to the right view. Then put the bone like that, so it's respecting the knee of the leg. I think it would be better if the shoes is looking forward like that, so select it and rotate it on the Z axis. It will make the rigging for the legs much easier. Okay, reselect the bones, press tab, go to edit mode, press E again and put it around here, and then press E again and push it just before the beginning of the toes. Then one more time for the toes. Pull this one up a little, like that. Try to make the bones in the middle of the leg as much as possible. View it from all the sides and try to make it in the middle, like that. All right, I will create the bones for the left side and the right side will be symmetrized from it. The next thing we need to do is rename the bones to something relevant. So go to this tab here and start renaming the bones. This one, for example, let's call it armpit.l. Make sure that .l is included in the name of the bone, because that is essential to symmetrize the bones to the other side. Okay, select the other one. I will rename all the other bones something relevant and add .l at the end of it. What I need to do now is parent these bone chains to the base bone here. As you can see, this bone chain starts from the armpit bone and ends with the bone of the gloves, and this one starts from the upper leg and ends with the toe. So I only need to parent the first bones in the bone chains to the base bone, and all the other bones after these two bones will be automatically parented to the base bone. Alright, so select these two bones by selecting one, then hold shift and select the other one. Keep holding shift and select the base bone, so it's the last bone selected. Now press Ctrl P, you will get the Make Parent menu, then select Keep Offset. You will notice now these dashed lines appeared. That indicates that these bones are now parented to this bone. Okay, let's try and attach the body and the clothes to the bones and see the influence of the bones on them. So select the body, press shift and hold, select the clothes, select the shoes and the gloves, maybe also select the straps. Now select the armature, make sure that the armature is the last object selected. Now press Ctrl P, you will get this menu, set parent to, and choose with automatic weights. What will that do is it will add weights to each of those bones to the mesh. The weights determine how much of influence these bones will have on the mesh. So to test the bones, press Ctrl Tab to go to pose mode, select the head bone for example, then press R. You will see that the mesh is now moving with the bone. You will notice that the eyes and the goggles are not moving with it because they are still not parented to this bone or attached to the armature. We will do that in a minute. Let's try and select other bones and try rotating them. You will notice that the right side is moving weirdly because there is no bones there yet. This will be fixed when we symmetrize the bone from the left side to the right side. And we will do that when we finish all the bones in the left side and we will symmetrize it one time to the right side. Let's start moving this bone. and see the influence it has on the mesh, you will notice that this part of the clothes is moving with it and it's not really accurate. That means that this bone has a lot of weight or influence on this part of the mesh. So let's check the influence of these bones on the mesh by checking out the weight paint. To do that, press Ctrl Tab to go to object mode, select the body, then press Ctrl Tab and go to weight paint. Alright, then from this tab under vertex group, you will notice there is all the bones that we have added to the character. Each of them have certain weight on this part of the model. So if we selected the head, for example, you will notice that the head bone is influencing this part of the mesh. The red color means that it has almost 100% influence, and the yellow colors is less, the green meaning 50% influence, and the blue means zero influence. Okay, let's check another bone, like the upper arm for example. You will notice that the upper arm is affecting this part of the mesh the most, but it's also affecting this part of the mesh by 50%, which is not something that we want because it's affecting this part of the clothes and it's moving in a weird way. So to fix that, there is two ways to go about it. The first one is by using the brush that we have here and paint the weight that we want for this part. Right now we will be painting with 1, meaning 100%. If I try to paint now, you will see that I'm painting with the red color. Let's undo that. If I change this weight to 0, I will paint with the blue color. I don't think that this is very efficient and it will result in unpredictable deformation for the mesh. Instead, I prefer to use another method, so go to object mode. Let's add more bones for these parts so that these bones take the influence from the other bones here. Let's proceed with it and you will understand. Select the armature, then press tab to go to edit mode, shift and right click to put the 3D cursor in this place. Now shift A to add another bone, scale it down by pressing S and move it like that. Select this vertex and move it to match this part of the mesh. Rotate around it and move it on the x-axis, like that. Go to the right side, keep extruding it and pushing it out on the x-axis like that. Okay, so right now, what will happen is, if we go to object mode, selected the body, the clothes and all the other objects like that, then selected the armature. Now if you press Ctrl P and selected with automatic weights, these bones will now have weights on the mesh and it will be affecting this part of the mesh. Let's retest it by going to pose mode. Let's try and move this bone. You will notice that this part of the mesh is not moving with it anymore. Alright, let's test the other bones. Let's check the head part. You will notice that the straps of the goggles are not moving with 100% influence like the head and it's deforming in a weird way. So let's do the same thing with the straps on the head as we did with this part of the clothes. So press tab to go to edit mode, shift and right click around this position, shift A to add another bone, rotate it like that, scale it down, rotate it on the Z axis and try to match the orientation of this part of the mesh. Go to the top view and start extruding and rotating around the goggles like that. Okay, select these vertices and push them down to be in the same position as the straps. Okay. Let's try and reattach the body, the clothes, and everything to the bones one more time by pressing Ctrl P with automatic weights. Let's try it again by moving this bone. You will notice that these bones are not moving with the head bone anymore because the new chain that we have added for these straps are not parented to the head bone. So let's go to edit mode by pressing tab, select this bone, press shift and hold, then select the head bone, press Ctrl P and keep offset. Right now this bone is parented to this head bone. If we go to pose mode and start moving it, you will notice that this bone chain is now moving with the head bone and also the mesh is moving along with it without any weird deformation. Okay, what if I want these bones to move with the head bone as well? Simply, I can go to edit mode, select this bone, shift and hold, select the head bone, then press Ctrl P, make parent, keep offset, and that will parent this bone to the head bone. Now if I move the head bone, you will notice that the straps are moving along with the head bone now. I noticed that the buttons are not moving. That's because we forgot to attach it to the bones. So select the buttons, select the armature, Ctrl P with automatic weights. Now if I go to pose mode, now it will be moving with it. Let's also attach the armpit bone to this bone so that the head bone moves all the arm like that. I notice that now this part of the mesh is moving too much. So let's add another bone here for the pelvic bone in order to remove this weird deformation that we just saw. Select this bone, press Shift D to duplicate it, rotate it, scale it down, and put it around this position. Rename this bone to maybe pelvic.l. Select the body, the clothes, shoes, then select the armature, Ctrl P with automatic weights. Go to pose mode, let's test it now. I still think that this part is still not deforming as I want. So basically what I do from here is just add more bones to this area and reattach it again to the mesh, and I keep doing that until I am satisfied with the deformation of the mesh. This is just another way of adding weights to the mesh. Instead of manually weight painting each bone, I just add more bones so that I control the weights that the bones have. I think the automatic weights of Blender is much easier and faster way to rig the mesh. So I'll add more bones to this part. Select the clothes, the body, and reattach them by pressing Ctrl P with automatic weights. And let's test it one more time. I think the deformation now looks much better. Let's try and parent the goggles and the eyes to this bone, so it's moving along with it. So in order to do that, press Ctrl Tab to go to object mode, select the goggles, press and hold Shift, and select the front glass part, then select the armature, press Ctrl P, you will get the parent menu. But instead of using with automatic weights, because that will make the goggles deform, and I don't want it to be deformed because it's a solid object, I want it to be moving all as one part and not deform like the body or the clothes. So instead of using with automatic weights, I will attach it to the bone. Okay, if you go to pose mode by pressing Ctrl Tab now, you will notice that this part is now moving along with the hip bone. Let's do the same thing with the hinges selected. For this part, I will need to apply the mirror so they are both one object. Then select the armature, press Ctrl P, then set parent to bone. Select the goggles and the front part, then press H to hide them. Select the upper eyelid, the lower eyelid, and the eyes itself. Then select the armature, press Ctrl P, set parent to bone. Now press Alt H, go to pose mode, and try to move them. You will now notice everything is moving with it. Okay, you will also notice that the hair is not moving along with the bones. So let's try and attach it very quickly. Go to object mode, select the hair. Because the hair is a curved object, you will not be able to attach it to the bones. So in order to be able to attach it, I need to convert it to a mesh. So to do that, I can go to object, convert to, then select mesh. But before that, I need to reduce the amount of resolution of the curve, so when I convert it to a mesh, it will not contain too much vertices. So go to this tab and change the resolution from 12 to about 2, and go down, change the bevel resolution from 4 to 2 as well. Now from object, convert to mesh. Now this curve has been converted to a mesh. I can add a subdivision modifier to it so it's smoothed out. Select it, then select the armature, Ctrl P, set parent to bone. Let's test it. Now it's moving along with the head bone. The last thing I want to do is symmetrize all the left bones that we have created to the right side. These bones that we have created here are not renamed yet, so I will rename it very quickly. I can just press Ctrl C to copy the name, select the other bone, Ctrl V, and enter. Okay, now select all these bones, the left bones, deselect the middle one, right click, then choose Symmetrize. All the bones will be mirrored to the other side. You will also notice that all the bone names have changed from .l to .r. Okay, I also noticed that these bones have to be starting from this position in order to have influence from the beginning of the straps. Alright, let's go to object mode, select the clothes, the body, gloves, shoes, the buttons, and the straps, then select the armature. Make sure that the armature is the last thing selected, then press Ctrl P. With automatic weights, let's test the bones. Go to pose mode. I think everything is moving as expected. Let's test all the bones. Let's also attach the teeth and the tongue to the armature for now. In the next parts, I will refine the rig. So just for now, I will attach it to the head bone so it moves with it. All right. That's it for this part. I hope that you found it useful. In the next part, we will continue refining the rig. If you want to follow up the rest of the series, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified as soon as a new part is uploaded. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.